Our first step is to open a text editor program. Even though we are simply typing, we cannot use a word processing program. We need a text editor that accepts 100% plain text. If you're not sure what that means, it's okay. It just means that we need a program that is specifically designed or dedicated to typing code. And luckily for us, the industry's most popular text editor program, even amongst top professionals, is completely free to download and use. So, right now, in a new tab in your web browser, I want you to search for Visual Studio Code. As of this recording, the official website's domain is code.visualstudio.com. Now, this program is created by Microsoft, meaning it's safe to install on our computer because it's from a reputable source. And regardless of whether you're using Windows, Mac, or Linux, you can see that it's completely free to download and use. So right now, I want you to pause this video lesson while you go and download Visual Studio Code. Once your download completes, then go into your computer's downloads folder, double-click the downloaded file, and you should be able to just click the next button through the automated installer. All of the default options or choices will be perfectly okay. Or if you're on Mac, just extract the downloaded file and then drop that into your applications folder. Okay, so pause this video, go download and install VS Code, and now from this point, I'm going to assume that anyone moving forward in the video has installed VS Code or Visual Studio Code. So now go ahead and open the program. The very first time you open the program, you might see a welcome screen that doesn't look exactly like this, but you can just go ahead and click the X to close that tab, and then the next time you open the program, it should look something like this. I see a welcome screen, and right now I just want to create a new file. There are several different ways to create a new file, but why don't we just use the file menu up in the top left corner and then click new file. Cool, so now we have this new empty place where we can begin typing. So in the content area here, you can see my cursor blinking, type this in with me. Let's create a heading level 1 tag, so less than, h1, greater than, and then let's just say this is a test. And then let's close out the heading level 1 tag, so less than, / h1, greater than symbol. Okay, and now our next step is to save this file so that we can open it and view it in a web browser. So you can either go up into the top left file menu and click file and then save, or you can use your keyboard shortcut, so that's Control and S on Windows or Command and S on Mac. So first of all, go ahead and choose a location on your computer that's easy for you to remember. So perhaps you can save it to your desktop, or a folder on your desktop. It's totally up to you, but just choose a location that you can easily find again in the future. And now for the name of the file, so in this Save As file name field, let's say My Page, and then this is the important part, .html. So the dot and then what comes after the dot, this is the file extension. So, for example, maybe you've heard people refer to a photo as a JPEG, right? So a photograph would be its file name and then .jpg. But since this is a web page, it's the file name, which can be anything you want, and then .html. So this tells the computer what type of file it is. Okay, once you've chosen that name, then let's go ahead and actually save this file. Okay, now at this point, I want you to go and locate that file using your computer's File Explorer. So in my case, I saved it to a folder on my desktop named LearnHTML. You likely saved it somewhere different on your computer, but I just want you to go and locate or find the file that you just created. Okay, now I want you to open a web browser, perhaps to a new empty tab, and then I want you to drag, so click and drag your new file that we just created, drag it on top of a web browser window, release it, and there we have it. You just viewed your first web page. Now, we must admit, though, that this is not a publicly available web page or website, right? We didn't purchase an actual real domain or .com, right? The address is just pointing towards our personal physical computer. This means you're the only one in the world who can view this web page right now. But for now, that's okay. At this point in the course, we're just trying to learn about HTML code. Later in the course, we can learn how to actually push our website or web pages live up onto the web so that you can share them with your friends, family, and colleagues with a shareable URL. But for now, don't worry about that aspect at all. We're just focusing on the actual HTML or content of the page. Feel free to make any changes to the HTML file. Save again, and then refresh the web browser, and you can see your latest changes appear right before you.